Okay, aloha. This is Jason from Lahaina Music, and we are finishing, hopefully, we'll see, we're finishing our comparison video on concert ukuleles. The first video was like $80 to $200. The second video was $180 through about $400, and this one's going to be $500 through like $2,500. So we're going to start off by looking at one of the winners from the previous video, which is this one. This is a Koaloha ukulele ASFM, which is all solid flame maple. And we're going to just use this as a benchmark to compare ukuleles to. We'll compare them to each other too, but it's useful to have something that's a benchmark. So here we go. So there's the sound of this ukulele. When we move up from there, that one's going to be made in China. That's, I think, one of the best products being made in China. This is made in a different place. This is a Koaloha Opio. Koaloha is a Hawaiian ukulele company, but they do have an overseas line, and this is made in Thailand. And this is actually a KCO02, which is a long neck concert, but the resonance of this is like the short neck. I'm just out of the regular neck one right now. I don't want to have to put it in this video, so we'll give you a sound comparison between this one, which is handmade overseas in Thailand, versus the Kala product. Compare that back to this one. Not even close, right? I mean, this is a good uke. That's just a vastly better uke. So that one would run in the regular neck variety. We would sell that for about $495 for comparison. This one we would sell for about $375. The big difference is that you're jumping to a handmade product versus more of an assembly line product. This is a better wood. This is a solid acacia. But wood doesn't say everything. A lot of what you do with the wood, because we've not all solid acacia ukes are necessarily, wow, that's a good uke. This one happens to be. That's a good uke. They also make this in a different variety with a spruce top. That's going to be this one here. So I'd like to do a tonal comparison between the spruce and the acacia now. This is a acacia back. The back and sides are the same, all solid. It just has a solid spruce top. So let's take a look at how this sounds in the mics. Screaming. That's a good uke. That's, how much is this one? This one we sell for about $594. Good uke. Let's compare it back to this one. So this one that seemed like a screaming uke compared to the Kala one doesn't seem quite as interesting to me, to my ear, as the spruce one. To the spruce. Yeah. They're both good, they're just different. This one's a lot brighter. This one would be probably, the other one would be, I would describe as maybe smoother. Finger style on the acacia. See, I'm not playing it different. It just doesn't. That spruce top one is like, holy cow, that's a uke. So, of course, I'll probably have that reaction several times as we go up to better ukes. We'll be like, holy cow, that's a good uke. Okay, so let's see. Let's set this one aside for a moment. This you might prefer one on the visual versus the other. That, you know, those things go into these decisions too. Normally this one has a tenor neck on it, and a concert body, so it's got the tenor tuning gear, but normally this one would have the same tuning gear as this, a compression tuner. Let's do some further comparisons. I'm gonna set this one aside over here. So I got lots of ukes arrayed, hopefully within reach here. The next one to compare to would probably be the, it depends on which direction we want to go in terms of price or in terms of where something's made. Let's jump to the Pepe Romero, which is this one. This is an Akoa wood. They also make it in a mahogany, which is a little less expensive, but not quite as pretty. Pretty uke. This is an interesting uke because it's called a tiny tenor. The scale length is actually tenor scale length, but the overall size of the uke is the same length as a concert uke, which is interesting. This comes with a low G string standard. It has a lot of clarity. I would describe it as clarity. Compare that to the Koaloha. This one again we would sell for about $809. This one I would describe as a uke with good clarity. This one's good uke. It's also twice as expensive. It's beautiful. Good uke. If you like something with clarity and you want something a little different that maybe you don't already have, a this or a that, you probably don't have one of these. Cool uke. All right, moving from this one is made overseas in Vietnam. So some of these have different locations that they're made. Let's compare next to the Keli'i. This is the Keli'i Gold series, which means Alcoa. And Keli'i's, the difference here is we're moving to a uke that's made in Hawaii. Now, it's not completely made in Hawaii because the machine, the wood is Hawaiian koa, but it's machine cut overseas and then set back here in Keli'i, assembles them here. And it's, I think it's just Keli'i still. For a while, he had a crew working with him, but now he's... it's just Keli'i. So it's like these. I remember we went and picked up a batch once and we met him at the airport and he drove up in his truck and gave us a box of ukes. Pretty cool. Okay, let's take a listen. So I'll describe this again as a uke with good clarity. Let's compare it back to the Koaloha. The Keli'i, by the way, we would sell for like $580. Tuned a little sharper than the others, so close enough for the video. The Koaloha versus the Keli'i. So this would be a lowest priced Hawaiian made uke, would be one way of looking at that in terms of it, how it places with the other things. Let's compare the Keli'i now to one that is all made in Hawaii instead of like the part of it made overseas or something like that, which some of these other ones, there are other ukes out there that are like made in the Philippines, but the action set here, stuff like that, are designed here, made somewhere else. But this is actually like a made here. This is a Koaloha. And this is a very different sound. I'll compare them directly. Here's Koaloha. Versus the Koaloha. Not even close, right? Not even close. Not even close. This is a wow. Like, I don't even need to play anything complex. You just play a C chord and you go, oh, wow. Okay, so all solid koa, all handmade in Hawaii. Let's do some finger style on it. Let's compare this to, how about this guy? The Koaloha Overseas with the spruce top. Back to the Hawaiian koa. This is better, but sorry about the truck that just drove by on the highway outside. But this one is better. I like its tone better, but it does show how good this one is. This is a very, very good uke at $594, like $600. This is a good uke. This one's twice that at $1,220. But it's a better uke. But this one, if you're like, don't want to go over $1,000, you want something almost as good as $1,000, this is a good uke. Let's compare this to the Keli'i. Very different resonance. Playing them both the same. I'm not plucking one harder than another. This one just goes, la! You know, it's like, oh, I love Koalohas. Okay, now let's compare this Koaloha to this Koaloha. This is the KCM00. This is the KCM25, which is a 25th anniversary edition. It looks a little different. It has the ebony on the headstock. Both of these ukes are ukes that we don't always have in stock. Like, you know, we can order them, and if they don't have them, they're making them by hand. If they're not ready, they're not ready. It's not like they're sitting in a warehouse somewhere. So all of these are kind of hit and miss in terms of availability. But let's compare these two side to side. Here's the silver, or the 25th anniversary silver, they call it. They're pretty close. Back to the silver. I guess I'll leave that up to you, which one you like better. I like them both. They're both very, very nice ukes. A couple differences to point out is the silver has a geared tuner here, and this one has a compression tuner. You might have a preference for one versus the other. The compression tuners are a little more traditional, arguably. The gear tuner is a little more modern. Sometimes some people say it's easier to tune with one or the other. It all depends on what your preferences are. It's kind of how that boils down. Well, these are both nice ukes. So those are from Koaloha. Let's now compare to a Kamaka. Running out of places to put ukuleles here. So this is the Kamaka HF2, all solid koa, all handmade in Hawaii by Kamaka. Kamaka is the longest standing ukulele maker in the state of Hawaii. They've been doing it over 100 years now. That's the Kamaka. These are $1,345. Let's compare that to the Koaloha. We'll do a little back and forth because they're a little different. $1,345. one thing I will say about kamakas is that as you play them more, they tend to open up more in terms of their tone. The kolohas, pretty much right out of the gate, are opened up in their tone. They're a little different. It's hard to say which one is better. They're just different. You can listen and hear. You can look. What's interesting about this kamaka, a couple years ago switched over to this. It looks like a compression tuner, but it actually is a geared tuner. I can't remember what the ratio is, but it makes it much easier to be accurate with your tuning, and it makes it much less likely to slip. Even though it looks like a straight through compression tuner, it's actually not. Cool tuners. I think it's Goto makes those. Let's do some finger style. Both very nice ukes. I'll let the microphones and the better speakers you play this back on, the better you're going to hear the nuances and difference. Let's compare one more here, because we have also the Kamaka Deluxe, which we also all, and the Kamakas, usually we order those, it's like 3 months, you know, who knows when they're going to come in. The Kamaka Deluxe we don't always have. Standard Kamaka. Back to the Deluxe. The difference there in tone, I would say, would be subtle. But this is also spectacular visually, with the binding around the edge. The selection of the koa. The fretboard's different. It's an ebony fretboard instead of a rosewood fretboard. And I have one of these in the tenor size. I love it dearly. Good uke. Let's compare it to... I got so many ukes here, it's hard to see. 25th anniversary silver, let's compare to that. Great uke. Kamaka Deluxe. Great uke. You get to decide. All of these are a leap ahead of the, I would call these all professional grade ukes. So they're a leap ahead of the sort of under $500 branch of ukes. They do go up in price. This one, the Kamaka Deluxe, is $25.45. Quite an investment, but quite an ukulele. I think I probably told the prices in these, but just in case I missed one in my enthusiasm to jump in, so we're gonna splice the video together here. Because we inadvertently got cut off there. Okay, we were doing a review of all of these. Let's see, let's start at the top. Kamaka Deluxe. This one is $25.45. Kamaka Concert. $13.45. Koaloha 25th Anniversary Edition Silver. This one's $13.70. Koaloha Concert, Hawaiian Made in Koa. One's $12.20. Pepe Romero. This is the tiny tenor, strung with a low G. This is 809. Keli'i Gold. This is 580. Koaloha Opio. They used to call them Opios, but they don't anymore. But an overseas made Koaloha. That's the spruce top. This is 594. Koaloha in the acacia. This one in the long neck version here. Is 540 without the long neck would be 495. And compare all of that back to arguably one of the winners of the previous batch of Ukes. Under 500. This one is 375. Hopefully that's helpful. If you have any other questions, you can leave them in a comment. We'll try to reply to those. If you want to click the like or the thumbs up or the subscribe or anything else to see more of our videos, that would be awesome, because that'll also help other people find them if you thought this was helpful. And hopefully it was. And aloha.